this often. So first poem is one I've read before and you heard. It's called If I Kill Myself Today. If I kill myself today, tomorrow's milk will curdle untended at the door. Some clothes in the washing machine will stay unwashed forever. 100 ants will gather in quiet celebration around some spilt tea in the kitchen. A desperate doorbell will fall from favor on deaf ears. If I kill myself today, dust will gather where my broom won't be reaching anymore. Ignored, a solitary banana will rot, surrendering itself to flies. A stubborn pigeon will wonder why she's not being chased out the window and gleefully invite some others in. Helplessly, three bottles of pills will age past their expiry date, their contents intact. If I kill myself today, a cell phone will beep a reminder at 9 a.m. tomorrow and every 10 minutes thereafter until its battery dies. A Gmail account will gather unread emails from known IDs for years before spam slowly takes over. A Facebook profile picture will find that it never needs to be updated ever again. But the elections will be held on schedule. The monsoons will come again this year. My aging father will grow even older. The building down the road will be redeveloped. Homes will be furnished. Furniture will be bought, will age and be replaced. The unmarried will get married. The unborn will be birthed. Newspapers will be printed and read and recycled. Tomatoes will be grown. Soup will be made. The kind I was prescribed for a healthier, longer life. You will have it out of a bowl. If you have it next week, you will shed a tear in my memory. It will fall in the soup. You will collect it in a spoonful and swallow it as you choke and break down. But if you have it next year, it will be too hot. So you will blow on it till it cools, and then you will swallow it spoonful by spoonful as you sit before the television, watching your favorite dinner time soap, cursing the ad breaks with the same intensity as today. If I kill myself today, the telecast timings will not change. From death to love. Love. It's called What Do I Do With You? The seat next to me is vacant. If you bought a ticket, you could be here now. Two rows up, across the aisle, a little girl plays chess. Must be her first ever game. Her bishop stands where her knight should be. Now the knight moves diagonally across the squares, off the board, and into this vacant seat. The little girl, she turns to me and says, check. You don't need a ticket. The train's leaving the station now. Faces outside this window become a blur as the game speeds up. You'll find me in a black square, that's if you come looking. I'll move, vacate my seat for you. Sometimes the ticketless are destined to journey. If you look two rows up across the aisle, the little girl will be making advances with her castle. She's changed all the rules, but you can stay for the ride.